I'm Lisa Rogers, and I'm mates with Robert Llewellyn.
What are you expecting from the screening tonight then, Lisa?
More of the same silliness that we've had from the rest of Red Dwarf. No, it's obviously a very serious, educational, sci-fi, physics. No, it's just going to be brilliant. It's just going to be the boys doing the same as they've done for the last however many years. It's pretty good.
Presumably you've been watching it sort of the whole way through. Is there anything that stands out for it about you?
Yeah, because, you know, I was only about six when it first started.
DVDs.
Such a lie. Like, I still remember watching the first Red Dwarf. I think I was about 15 or 16. And there was an episode with Craig Charles saying, "So who's Lisa?" Of course, I got very excited because it was my name in it. And yeah, I've just been a fan ever since, really. But what I love is seeing Robert Llewellyn, without his mask on and then with his mask on, because, of course, you know, I know him quite well. So it's interesting seeing the difference.
How does he sort of approach that? Because, I mean, that's a hell of a thing to do, get all that get-up on.
Takes a very long time. I'm trying to think if I'm allowed to say a story.
Go.
Yeah. No, he used to get quite cross because he'd come have to get up at 5 o'clock in the morning to come down to glue the mask on his face. And he'd be coming down the lift. Certain other members of the cast, I won't mention any names, were coming in at five, like, "Yeah, like Bobby." Oh, I've given it away with the accent.
I wonder who that could be.
Don't know. Chris Barry. It was Chris Barry.
And why do you think the series is so enduringly popular? It's been over 20 years now.
God, I've no idea. It's rubbish, isn't it? No, I'm joking. I think it's sci-fi, isn't it? People love comedy. It's undoubtedly hilarious. Fantastic writing. I mean, Ed's a brilliant writer. And you've got some, okay actors in it. I suppose, but no, it's just very funny. And it's left field. It's not really like anything else, I think. That's a good thing about it.
And what can we expect from this series? Is there anything different, anything bombastic going on?
God, you don't think Robert tells me anything, do you? He's like, "No, you're not getting any serious because you're my mate. I'm not saying anything. I've got to wait like everybody else."
If you had to give one message to Red Dwarf fans, what would it be?
Watch the next series. It's going to be great.